So in this video, I'm going to show the calculator function 2PropZ test. And the reason to use this would be that you're doing a hypothesis test for two proportions, comparing two sample proportions. So we have an example here. It is a fake allergy medication called Inflaminex, and they're looking at side effects of it. And does the medication cause more bloody noses than people who take a placebo, so something that is not medicine. And they look at the proportion of those that got the bloody noses with and without the medication. So notice that we're given two sample sizes, as well as how many people from those sample sizes got the bloody noses, and that's what we're comparing here. So to find 2PropZ test, you'll go to stat, over to tests, and then you'll scroll down. You'll see that for me, that's number 6. So I could have pressed number 6, or I'll scroll down and then choose number 6. So what we need here is just to write out our proportions, numerator, denominator. So we have 520 people out of 2,103 people that received the medication and had a bloody nose as a side effect. For those that received the placebo, we have 368 that had the bloody nose, and it was 1671 that took the placebo. So you do want to make sure your X is less than your N, because X is essentially successes and N is number of trials. And so in that case, this is what we have. Now, in terms of deciding what our next part is going to look like, we look at the last sentence. Is there significant evidence to conclude that the proportion of the Inflaminex users who experience bloody noses as a side effect is greater than the proportion of the placebo group? So we're looking at a greater than, and since my X1N1 is for Inflaminex, that would mean that I'd be looking at, is P1 greater than P2? So I'd want to highlight that and then press calculate. So when I do that, I'm going to get this information. So notice there's a lot here, but there's very little that you need. It reminds you of what your alternative is, which is P1 being greater than P2. You have your test statistic, which is a Z value. You have your P value, which is the probability that you would have had data like you did, or data more extreme if the null hypothesis were true, in this case that P1 is equal to P2. Then they're giving you just the proportion, the P1 hat and the P2 hats. So they're just doing 520 divided by 2,103 and giving that to you as a decimal, the same with the placebo proportion. The next value that you're given is, some textbooks actually call it P bar, which is a pooled proportion. So it's the X1 plus X2 divided by N1 plus N2. So that's used possibly in situations where you're doing more by hand, that could be useful. And then of course, just our sample sizes for N1 and N2. So again, if you're gonna be making some sort of decision and conclusion, the focus that you are going to want will be on the test statistic and the p-value. And that's an example of 2PropZ test.